Hey everybody, it's Ms. Barnacle again. All right, our next module is on dividing fractions. Okay, if you look at the screen, we have another little ditty about dividing fractions. It says dividing fractions is easy as pie, just flip the second and multiply. Second meaning the second fraction in the problem. Okay, so I'm going to work four problems on the board for you and we're going to practice this little saying. Okay? Let me change to the board. All right, we have four fractions up here. The first set of fractions we have is 5/8 divided by 2/3. So we follow the rule, dividing fractions, easy as pie, flip the second and multiply. So it didn't say I do anything to the first fraction, so I'm gonna leave it that way. We flip the second, and when you flip it, that's the word reciprocal. The word reciprocal means to take whatever the fraction is and flip it over. So when I flip it, it becomes 3/2. And multiply, so change divide to multiplication. And then we're gonna follow the rules. We just got through learning the rules for multiplying. Multiplying fractions is no problem. Top times top and bottom times bottom. So when I look at these two fractions, you ask yourself, do they have anything in common where I can reduce them first? 5/2, no. 3/8, no. So since they have nothing in common, I can do top times top, 15, bottom times bottom, 16. And 15/16 has nothing in common. And just a little hint, anytime you have a fraction where the numerator and the denominator are just one digit apart, like 15 and 16, you'll never be able to reduce that because there's nothing in between them that's an actual whole number. All right, so let's go to the next one. We have 5/8 again. Easy as pie. We're going to flip the second. The second fraction's 3/8, so we're going to flip it to 8/3 and multiply. Now look at your fractions. Can you reduce anything? Yeah, I can reduce the 8s. 8 divides into 8 once. 8 divides into 8 once. Now I do multiplying fractions is no problem. Top times top, 5. Bottom times bottom, 3. Sometimes you can leave it like this, 5/3, but remember, if you are going to talk about measuring anything, you want to make sure that you know how to turn that into a mixed number by saying 3 divides into 5 one time and it leaves 2 left over. So that would be 1/2 if you want to change it to a mixed number. All right, let's look at the next one. 36/15. First fraction stays the same. Flip the second and multiply. So we're going to flip it, which makes 5/12. And then we say, okay, well, do they have anything in common? Well, yeah, the 5 and the 15 do. 5 divides into 5 once. 5 divides into 15 3 times. And then I'll look at 36/12. Now, if you don't automatically know from the multiplying one, the multiplying module, that 12 times 3 is 36, sometimes you can use your factors to help you get there. But 12 divides into 12 one time, and 12 divides into 36 3 times. And then I have a 3. Let's do this. So when I do multiplying fractions, it is no problem. I have top times top, which makes 3. Bottom times bottom, which also makes 3. Now, 3 divided by 3. Anytime you have a number divided by itself, it is not in simplest form. Simplest form would be, how many times does 3 go into 3? Once. So that would be 1 would be the lowest form for that fraction. Okay, the last one, when you're dividing fractions, what if you divide by a whole number? In the previous lesson, I told you, make sure that all whole numbers have a 1 under them, okay? And that's because when you do division and you flip the second, if you don't put the 1, you're gonna forget that 4/1, the reciprocal, when you flip it over, is 1/4, okay? Anytime you have a whole number, put a 1 under it in the denominator and then you flip it, okay? All right, so can I reduce any of this? Yes, 2 divides into 2 once, 2 divides into 4 2 times, and then you do top times top, 1, bottom times bottom, 6. Now those are all in lowest terms, and that's as much as we can do. And that ends our lesson on dividing fractions.